Hey everyone, thanks for coming. So my name is Aler Lopes. I'm a VP of Design and Animation at Outfit7. I'll be talking to you about our latest game that we launched in November. I'll first just talk a bit about Outfit7 in case you don't know so much about it, about us. And then I'll talk about Tom Pool, which is our latest game, how we came to do it. It was from my experience in the company, it was the one that we had the most trouble figuring out what the story of the game was and what the gameplay was all about. So about us, our success. So the first column, this is App Annie data of 2017 worldwide Google Play games free downloads. We are on second. On the iOS 8, and games-wise, so My Talking Tom, number 4, and My Talking Angela, number 11. So this is where, of course, super happy about it, and we'll this year we'll continue to create new games that hopefully will continue to be on the top charts like these ones. So what does this mean? We have over 7 billion downloads, and we have 348 MAU. So, of course, this. How did we get here? We have our first game that probably you know, My Talking Tom. This is a Tamagotchi game where you take care of Tom. He grows, you feed him, you take him to the toilet, you play games with him. Then we have our female version, more targeted to female audience, which is My Talking Angela. It's similar in some cases, but it has other features like, for example, you have brushing your teeth, you have like makeup, you have face paint, you have shoes, which is really popular. Then we have My Talking Hank, which is our more goofy character. The game has some similarities, and then if you see on the image, those animals in the back. So this is a different feature where you place toys, you place food, you attract animals, and you take pictures of them. You build your collection of animals, and you upgrade, and you get new stuff. And then we have a very different one of all those three that are Tamagotchi ones. We have Talking Tom Gold Run, which is a runner game where you run to collect gold bars. You use those gold bars to build your house, to upgrade your house, to unlock new worlds, unlock new game mechanics. We have like the latest. We have like I think 7 different worlds or 8 different worlds. And the robber, if you see at the end of it, it's our like antagonist in the story. We have all these other apps that I won't be talking about, but they are contributing a lot to our whole ecosystem. If you see it, the first one, Talking Tom, was the first one that created all the success. Then we have also video content that supports our apps. Talking Tom and Friends animated series. So this is a full CGI series. It's worldwide on YouTube, and then you have also TV, and you have also Netflix as well, and some other online video platforms. We have Talking Tom and Friends minis. This was originally, this is like a stylized version of our characters, a 2D. Originally, it was meant to more of an Asian market, but actually realized that even on Western markets, it's actually pretty popular, and we are doing new seasons of it. Talking Tom shorts. This was actually the first video content that we created. This is like 1 minute, 1 minute and 15 seconds of little adventures of Tom, Angela, and Hank. There's like no voice acting or something. It's just like pantomime and funny situations. Trailers, of course, we have every time we launch a new game, we do the trailers to tell about the story of the game, the content of the game, to attract our users to check it out. Gameplay, of course, gameplay videos that show sometimes tutorials of how to do something, other times just to show the content of our games. And the last one, this is like some lifestyle videos, like 3 minutes, 3 minutes and a half long. This is more about Angela talking about day-to-day experiences, like sometimes is back to school, more educational point of view of videos. So content-wise, so we have 17.3 billion views across all video platforms, 17 million YouTube subscribers, and on TV, like I mentioned before, 160 territories. So this brings us to Talking Tom Pool, the game that we created, the last one. So on this one, we started in a very different way that we actually started usually our games. So this one, we had the mechanic that we tested before, did some prototypes, and we knew that it was fun. So it was a sling mechanic. You just sling colors against each other. They merge. So that was the base idea. So I'll show. This is the video of Talking Tom Pool, in case you didn't.
Comes an exciting new game, Talking Tom Pool. Match colorful floaties with your favorite characters in hundreds of awesome pools and use power-ups like these rockets. Join Talking Tom on a wild ride and create your very own dream water park. Build the most amazing water slides and celebrate the fun with fireworks. Only in Talking Tom Pool. Download now and play.
Yeah. So here you could see a bit of the game board. You saw also the water park. I'll come back to it a bit later, but just wanted to show you a sneak peek of it. So the idea, like I mentioned before, was the mechanic. I'll show you now a few of the first concepts that we did and how far away we were from actually this idea. This came after quite a few months of concept art, of back and forth, of bouncing ideas back of each other. So we started actually with this. So originally we started with this idea of, as you see, you have the board, you have basically the mechanic was there. The idea was, okay, we'll start maybe we have some donuts and then you have a party and then you do the levels to get stuff for your party. Like this was our hub. So imagine you sling the donuts, you'd get a cake after a level or two levels. Then you would be slinging, the idea was vinyl records to get the speakers and the music, then the music would kick in, and then you'd get the balloons, you start to build your hub for your party, you'd start to attract visitors, you'd start to come in, you'd get your friends would come in, you could then log in with Facebook, la la la. This was the original idea. And then for us, looking back, we always did our games in portrait mode. And as we did the prototype and we started to have things in the game, we started to see that actually in landscape mode was actually even better to play. And then it came to a point of, should we actually risk it and do landscape mode? And then we just went like, it's better, we're still developing the hub, it actually worked better in landscape. So then we went like, okay, the decision is made, went landscape. And then if you see here, there's also like this was, at some point we had these music monsters for the music of the game. And then there was still an issue, which was we still had an issue of you couldn't really connect with the characters as you were playing the game. It was fun, you could play it well, there was no issues with the gameplay at all, but you just, over time, you didn't connect with it. And we had a big issue, for us at least, that we had our characters that our users love, but they were becoming secondary in the game because we were like, okay, I guess the users will spend 80, 90% on the board and then the rest on the hub. And then on the board, you know, if it was the donuts idea or that stuff, actually our characters weren't there. So then we're like, what if we have, it's a party, what if we have dancing cats? This is like balloons, is a party, so maybe it's that. They have eyes, we relate a bit more. We're like space cats, because as the gameplay, you are slinging against each other, so we were like, okay, it needs to be an area that it feels natural that things are bouncing around, but it still really wasn't what we were looking for. And then it just came to a point where we're like, look, we have to use our brand, which is, because all of those ideas, our brand was there, but it was, on the corner and then on the hub. It wasn't really on the core of the game, which was the gameplay. And then it came to a point of all concept artists in the company, all the art directors did concepts on what should that board be and what the story of the game should be, to the point where one of the guys did this concept first, which was our characters on the board, if you see each of them with a different color. so that you have a usability friendly. The last one is like the rainbow power-up with a unicorn, because it's fun. And then this was when we first saw this image, then we're like, yep, I think we're on the right track. And then he did the overall concept of the board. This was the first concept when you look at it, then we were like, yep, this is it. On all the concepts before we did, I could spend 1 hour just talking, showing you all the concepts that we did, of all the stories that we did, all the merging elements that we tried. But then this one was the one that, when we saw that, okay, that's it. We can imagine already all these different worlds around the board, all the cool stuff that we can do. And then we had our board finally. Okay, so it's cool, they're on the water. It feels naturally that you do this. Everyone has been in a pool or in a water park, or it feels natural that you can bump into your friends. It's pretty natural. And then it just came to the point of what is then the hub. To be honest, it didn't take that long that we reached the water park. This was actually the concept that the art director did, actually. And it was just like, as soon as we saw this one, like, I would say most of the people in the company were convinced that this was it. We showed it around to a few people, did a few tests, and we were like, okay, the board works, the hub works, it makes sense that you play levels to get something, to upgrade your water park. At this moment, if you see here, we had already the pirate design, like the mountain. Actually, when you look at this concept, which was like the first concept, a lot of our what ended up in the game right now came from this first concept. I'm out of time, and actually, my last slide. So what this bring to was over 1 million downloads by the third day of launch, 5 million within 10 days, and just a fun fact, over 1,000 years cumulative gameplay within the first 20 days. That's it. Visit us at the booth 132. I can then talk to you. There's more people also from the company here. Any questions that you have, and feel welcome to come and join us, talk with us. Cheers, thanks.